Is it possible for our lives to be at peace? With all that comes at us during the day, with our schedules, with the many things that we're involved in life, with the easy access that people has to our lives through even our cell phones, with the difficulties and challenges that we face, can we live our lives with peace? Jesus said, "Peace I leave thee." His desire is for us to not only have moments of peace, but live a life of peace. Colossians tells us that God's desire is that the peace of God rule our hearts. Meaning this, meaning that peace is in charge. It comes from the word government. And God desires for the peace to rule our hearts. You know, it's something that is found in God. The Bible describes God as the God of all peace. He is Jehovah Shalom. The Bible even tells us that Jesus is the Prince of Peace. And yet in the New Testament, we learn that part of the fruit of the Spirit of God is peace. It's found in everything that God is, peace. It's what God wants us to have our hearts ruled by. That's difficult. I realize that. I live life just like you, and I've got things going on in life. It's crazy. I've got situations that I'm believing God for that at night I lay down and I have to make this decision to live in peace. Well, I believe God's word will show us that. I think the first thing that we have to do is this. We truly have to take inventory of our thoughts. I know with my kids, when they were growing up, they would say something. I'd say, is that a bad thought or is that a good thought? Romans 8 tells us this in verse 6. It says that every thought we have either leads to life. Thoughts of the Spirit of God, fruit of peace, lead to life and peace. But thoughts of our flesh, thoughts where of the negativity that can go on, where the enemy tries to rule those thoughts, bring death, meaning this, they lead us down a road away from peace. So we have to inventory our thoughts. What are the things that you are thinking of? It's pretty easy to know what your day is like because most of us either post it on Twitter or post it on Facebook or we text someone, and they're usually our thoughts. So we have to ask ourselves, are those thoughts negative? Are they positive? Are they from the Spirit of God? Meaning this, I can go throughout the day and have thoughts of, you know what, it's going to be a bad day. We sometimes know that when we wake up out of bed. I remember when I used to wake up out of bed at 5 in the morning and my child wanted to be fed, and then they have an earache, or then they're sick, and we say, oh, it's just going to be a bad day. Already our thoughts begin to take us down a path. Take inventory of those thoughts. And I want to encourage you, as those negative ones may rise up, I encourage you to now go to God with your thoughts. The Word of God tells us in Isaiah 26:3, it says, perfect peace, meaning the ultimate, is found in the person whose mind, whose actions, whose everything in life is stayed on God, meaning leaning on God. In Job chapter 22, it tells us this. It says to acquaint yourself with the Lord. That means to truly go to God with everything. And it says your life will be a life of peace. So I want to encourage you, as those thoughts come, run to God. Just in that moment, say, Lord, I need you right now. I need you to take those thoughts. Tell me what you think about it. A lot of people will not only tell you what you want to hear, but maybe tell you something contrary to what you want to hear. I remember even times with my kids, I even ask them something, and you know how kids are so truthful, and yet they'll give me the truth, and yet that's not even what God says or God thinks. What thoughts are you thinking? Have you gone to God with those thoughts? Once we go to God with our thoughts, something really powerful happens. He replaces our thoughts. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, 4-5 tells us this, that we take our thoughts and we set them up against the very knowledge of God. It's the standard. And as God tells us, this is what I think about this situation. This is what I say. God's word is the rule, is the government of this world. And how powerful it is when we get a truth of what God says and we put it on the inside of our hearts. Take the word of God. Replace that thought. After we've replaced that thought, I think one of the most powerful things that we can do is we can speak that thought. Just say it out loud. Throughout the day, many times, I just say what God says. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 and 7, it talks about this. It says, be anxious for nothing. That seems difficult, but it gives you the remedy for that. With prayer, meaning go to God, supplication and thanksgiving, it says, make known your request. What it's saying is declare and decree to God what He says. And it says this, then the peace that passes all understanding, we can't even fathom it, will come into our hearts. Speak it, say it out loud. As you say something, you can't think something. It's an incredible tool. So speak out loud what God says. And then lastly, we respond to that very word that God says. We have to act out. In Isaiah 32, 17, it says, the product of righteousness, the product of responding to what we know God's word says, is peace. So what does that look like? You say, Dina, help me. I don't know. Take me through it. I'll just give you a real practical of what I'm in my life even right now in the transition as we've relocated our family. It has not been easy. But as we've relocated our family to Kentucky, we've transitioned our lives. We're waiting on God. We're trusting God. And many nights as the kids have transitioned to new schools and finances look different, man, I am telling you, thoughts come. One of the thoughts that a lot of times, you miss God. You didn't hear God. What are you doing in the middle of nowhere, down south in a difficult place? And I have found myself more times than one just running to God, just simply going to God and say, God, what do you say about this? I've even had people say, you are foolish. But God, what do you say about this? You know, fear can come in, but God has not given us a spirit of fear. And I remember the first time as we got into Kentucky, and I've just stayed in this place. This has been the replaced thought that I have on the inside of me. I'll never forget. Open up the Word of God and see what God says and find out what God says. And He said to me, Dina, I have a future and I have a hope. Will you trust me with that? And there's a scripture that says, those that wait on the Lord, their strength will be renewed. As you wait, that's a promise from God. I'm not getting weary. I'm not getting tired. No, my strength is being renewed because that's what God says. So you replace that thought. He has a future. He has a hope. I say it. Sometimes, as soon as that thought comes, I'll say it and repeat it. You have to replace the thought. Then you have to say it. You have to speak it. Faith rises up in me, the Bible says, by hearing and hearing of the word. So as we speak it, as we say over and over, some of you have a low self-esteem. Some of you may be in poor health. The Bible says, by His stripes we are healed. I've had cancer. I've been diagnosed with that. And there are times that all I said over and over is, by God's stripes, by what Jesus did, I'm healed. I'm healed. I'm healed. When I say that, fear and the negativity and the thoughts that lead to death leave me. So I've said over and over that God has a future and God has a hope. I encourage you, get a promise of God and say it and say it and say it. Another thing that you can do is get somebody else to agree with you. The Bible says there's power in agreement. Peace begins to permeate and rise up on the inside of your heart. Now you need to respond. Fear can cripple us. Depression can begin to set in. Peace permeates us to be able to respond. The acts of righteousness, the acts of responding to God's word, the acts of every day, me seeking God, what is it? I'm going to get up today. I'm going to give everything I've got in today. I'm going to wait on you. I'm going to rest in you because I trust you. I'm going to respond. I am going to move to Kentucky because you asked me to. As you begin to respond, there's one thing that my husband and I have said over and over through this transition. There's no substitute for peace. We may not have all the answers. I may not have seen the manifestation of everything that God has for us in being down in Kentucky, but I know one thing. I lay my head down and I have peace. And there's no substitute for that. It takes discipline. It takes a process. And I encourage you, if you'll implement these things each and every day, you'll find peace. It's God's desire for you. Will you truly live a life of peace?